As Dan Held said on Twitter, if your financial advisor hasn't recommended Bitcoin yet, fire them. And the reason is because Bitcoin has been the best performing asset for the past 10 years. The thing about welcome aboard the Bitcoin Express. My name is Chase. Let's get to it. Just last week, MassMutual, one of the largest insurance companies, bought $100 million worth of Bitcoin. And I was excited. You probably were as well. So what I did is I went over and I texted my friend who I always speak to about Bitcoin. He likes to argue, he doesn't believe in it, but we get into good discussion. So I sent him the story, MassMutual is buying Bitcoin. And he said, big deal. It's like 0.01% of their portfolio. And the truth is, he is correct. The investment for MassMutual represents 0.04% of MassMutual's $235 billion general investment account. So as we can see, it's not a lot of money. But in the end of the day, it's buying Bitcoin. And what I said to him is, do you think MassMutual is the only company that has cash reserves or that has money to invest? You're saying there are no other companies out there that can put in 1%, maybe even 0.05%. Maybe there are companies out there that want to put in more, 4, 3, 5%. He still didn't agree. And when I say things like this, and when you say them as well, people don't listen. But as always, sooner or later, someone comes along and validates our statements. And just today, December 14th, 2020, a JP Morgan strategist came along and stated that in the longer term, a $600 billion catalyst potentially awaits the dominant cryptocurrency, speaking about Bitcoin. And he stated a 1% allocation from pension funds and insurance firms in the US, Eurozone, UK, and Japan would amount to $600 billion added to Bitcoin. And why did he state this? He said this because the optimistic stance towards the Bitcoin price from JP Morgan comes after MassMutual purchased $100 million worth of Bitcoin. Like I stated, we see these things all the time, the people that have been in the crypto space for years, and typically we'll state it, people will look the other way, but someone comes along and validates our statements. And now with this happening, it sets a precedent across the insurance and the pension fund sector that Bitcoin is a legitimate store of value. And this is what I really like about this new story. This is only speaking about a 1% allocation from pension funds and insurance firms. So just pension funds and insurance firms. This doesn't even account all the other cash that is sitting out there with the institutions. And it's only including US, Eurozone, UK, and Japan. So it's not even the whole entire world. There is so much money sitting on the sidelines with institutions. Did you know that Apple has $191 billion in cash? Sooner or later, my belief is that they will put some money into Bitcoin. Not saying it's gonna be 5% or 3%, maybe not even 1%, it might be 0.01%. And not only do they have money, Google has even more cash sitting on the sidelines. There is so much money sitting with these companies. Sooner or later, I do believe that they're gonna put a small percentage into Bitcoin. And I'm gonna tell you exactly why it makes sense for them. We also had this year Paul Tudor Jones hedge fund come out stating that they're buying Bitcoin. And Paul Tudor Jones said he likes Bitcoin even more now. The rally is still in the first inning. Paul Tudor Jones has set the precedent for Wall Street to go ahead and buy Bitcoin. At this point, it is becoming irresponsible for large institutions to not have Bitcoin on their balance sheet. As Dan Held said on Twitter, if your financial advisor hasn't recommended Bitcoin yet, fire them. And the reason is because Bitcoin has been the best performing asset for the past 10 years. The thing about Bitcoin is that when you put in just 1% into your portfolio, it acts as a hedge because of the asymmetric risk that comes along with Bitcoin. A fund might put 1% or less into Bitcoin and they might lose it all, just like they lose other assets on their balance sheet. But on the other side, if Bitcoin does well, which it has done well since it has been created, it outweighs all the other losses that institutions get from other assets on their balance sheet. So far, It has done very well, and finally institutions are catching on. And that's why they're putting in 1%. They're not putting in 20, they're not putting in 30, they're putting in 1%, maybe even less. But there are companies out there that are putting in more than 1%. There's a website called bitcointreasuries.org, and it shows a list of publicly traded companies that are buying Bitcoin, adding it to their balance sheet. This list is big. And I remember when this list came out, I made a video on it. There was maybe like three or four companies on here. And when I made that video, I said, this list is going to grow. And that's exactly what has happened. And I'm going to state it again today. This list will grow and grow and grow. These companies have more than 1% into Bitcoin. But I really do believe, and I think you watching as well, that companies in the future, institutions, all sorts of firms will put in 1%, maybe even less, into Bitcoin, but it really adds up. And the funny part is, everything we just spoke about is not even the market that Bitcoin was going after. This is just the cherry on top. The market that Bitcoin was going after was the gold market. Bitcoin is essentially gold 2.0. And the gold industry is worth $10 trillion. And many people out there in the Bitcoin space believe that Bitcoin will capture the full $10 trillion market cap. I myself don't know if this is possible, or I don't know when this will happen, but I do believe it will gain some share from the gold market. Will it be 50%? Will it be 1%, 5%? Even if it's 5%, even if it's 10%, that's a lot of money. So again, I'm making the statement, maybe you made these statements as well, and people say, what are you talking about? Bitcoin will never take any market share from gold. But as always, someone comes along and validates our statements. Just this year, in December, this month, JP Morgan stated that gold will suffer for years because of Bitcoin. At this point, for a lot of us that have been in the crypto space for the past few years, it gets pretty frustrating. We say these things and we show evidence, but people look the other way. But now these big players are coming out and proving our statements. And when we look at the market cap for Bitcoin and we see it's only $358 billion, this is nothing. It's a little pebble. There is so much room for growth. And that's why when people such as the Winklevoss twins come out and say that a Bitcoin price rise to $500,000 is inevitable. People look at this and they start to think this is impossible, this is crazy. But when you start to understand the numbers and how large these markets are and where the money is actually coming from, then you start to understand that these numbers are actually possible. Will it happen this year? Will it happen next year? Who knows? But the bottom line is that with enough time, maybe it'll be 10 years, maybe it'll be 20 years, these numbers, these sky high rocket prices for Bitcoin are actually possible. But nothing goes straight up. Even till this point, Bitcoin has gone up to $20,000. Along the way, there are huge crashes, 50%, 60%, 70%, 80%. So even if Bitcoin, or really any asset, were to go up to a level of 50K, 100K, 200K, 300K, it's not going to go straight up. So the best thing a person can do is not read some article telling them that they should buy Bitcoin. It's not listening to someone on YouTube saying when you should get in or when you should get out. The best thing a person can do is study Bitcoin just like they would study anything else, whether they wanted to become a doctor or a lawyer or an accountant. It does take time. It does take effort. Because one of the hardest things about Bitcoin, it's not getting in early, getting out early. It's not making the best day trade, know exactly what's going on with the news. The hardest thing to do in Bitcoin is hold on to your Bitcoin, to have strong hands. And the only way you can get strong hands is by understanding what Bitcoin really is. Because even if you were to say, you know what, when the price goes down, I'm not selling, I'm going to buy more. It's easy to say it, but when it comes that time, very few people will be able to do it, because if you don't understand what you're actually holding, it's going to be very hard to practice what you say. Subscribe to the channel, learn crypto. You'll learn everything you need to know here on the Bitcoin Express. Like the video. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time.